But are they getting some of this money too to help with this
yes,
relief?
Yes, they are.
Okay, let me ask you one question before you take off. Thank you for coming, Ms. Glossy.
Welcome
to Minnesota. I have a question that I wanted to ask about. It's been a war torn in Somalia over two decades. It's getting worse now. There's a famine going on in Somalia. What is Obama's administration are doing to establish real government going on in our country, Somalia? Can you answer that question, please?
Well, I think that Congressman Ellison addressed this issue before. As he was speaking, I was thinking, it shows how much older I am than he is, because I was thinking much farther back. There was a time, of course, of imperialism that left its terrible mark on colonialism, that left a terrible mark on Africa and the continent of Africa. This was followed by the Cold War, where Russia, the Soviet Union, and the United States competed for the support of different countries. And when the Cold War was ended, they left Africa awash in weapons, but without taking a great deal of responsibility for what would come next. And so now we are in a new era from there, with the poverty, with the starvation, alleviation of poverty, spread of disease, HIV, AIDS, and all the rest of that. It took a terrible toll on Africa. But now, with communication and all of the spotlight being on Africa, and the fact that we do not want it to be a hotbed for violence, and poverty creates a fury of despair, as I mentioned earlier. So it's a long history and a path that we have to see our way out of. And what we're talking about here today relates to feeding people, giving them an act of friendship that hopefully supports the democratic efforts in Somalia.
Right. Also, one more thing. Like Mr. Ellison said, Somalia needs to be recognized as Somalia, not going to Nairobi,
right,
not going to neighbors. Always has been said, when you want to go to Somalia, you always say, we're going to Kenya, Nairobi. Somalia needs Somalia to be established. As you know, Al-Shabaab and also other militants who's not non-Somalis are recruited because of Al-Qaeda mentality, and they're all in Somalia. What do you say about that, and what the U.S. government doing about it?
The administrator already addressed the fact that these meetings are now taking place in Mogadishu. But in any of those places, like if you go to Khartoum or some places there, you could almost, my colleague Frank Wolf always says to me, you could call a meeting of every terrorist organization in the world in Khartoum, and you could have the meeting in 20 minutes, because everybody's there. Because everybody's there. We have to change that.
We need
change. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, ma'am.